Dear learners, welcome to the NIOS studio. I am Savitri Singh, National Consultant of Early Childhood Care and Education. Today's lesson is Planning Developmentally Appropriate ECCE Curriculum. Our subtopic is Program Planning. So let us, why planning is necessary? Planning is necessary for your children's all-round development. So let us see how to plan. Program planning is of three types: long-term planning, medium-term planning, and short-term planning. Long-term planning is annual planning, and medium-term planning is term-wise planning. Short-term planning is weekly and for daily. Okay, let us discuss the long-term planning. Long-term planning, what the things we have to keep in our mind and why long-term planning. So for long-term planning, what to plan? We have to plan the themes. What are the theme we are going to take in whole years? And what will be the curriculum of the whole year, for the whole years? Then teaching strategy, which teaching strategy we are going to adopt. Then comes play materials, what are the play materials we have to purchase. The furniture, about the furniture, we have to talk, we have to think. And then the budgeting, the whole years, how much we have to spend money and how much budget is with us. Okay. Now, we are coming on medium-term planning. This is monthly or term-wise planning. And for 3 months, here we have to identify the theme. What are the themes we are going to take in 3 months? What will be the teaching strategy for that? And TLM, what TLMs we are going to use for that themes? And recording the children's progress. Recording the children's progress, that is also very important, and we have to decide in 3 months. Okay, now comes short-term planning. This will be weekly and daily planning. This is more specific because we have to take one thing. We have to take one thing, and for that we have to decide the teaching strategy. We will have to decide the TLMs, what are the TLMs we are going to use related to that particular theme, and then additional support, what are the additional support we are getting, then variety of activities we have to decide, and TLMs also, what I have told you, and what are the resources, physical resources also we have to use it. Now, here is the example for short term, one, weekly planning. This is the example of weekly planning. Here, all the domains are here: language development, cognitive development, physical and motor development, socio-emotional development, creativity and aesthetic appreciation. Theme is animal. So, on Monday, for language development, what will we do? We will take conversation activity, and in conversation what we are going to talk, we will talk on cat and dog. We have taken two animals and we will talk on, the discussion will be on cat and dog. There will be one story related to the animals, one rhyme related to animals, picture book reading. There should be picture book reading, maybe this type of picture book reading. These are the pictures, and children can read the picture. Okay. So now this is language development. On Monday, for cognitive development, what will be the activities? The first activities is matching the animals, matching the picture of animals. Pre-number concept, big and small. Big and small. Okay. And then physical and motor development. For physical and motor development, again fine and large motor. For fine motor, free hand drawing. You can ask the children to draw whatever you want, whatever your favorite animals you can draw. Large motor development, on Monday we are going to ask them animals walk. We will do animals walk and ball play. For socio-emotional development, we can do role play on Monday. Creativity and aesthetic appreciation, we can ask them to dance and we will ask them to do vegetable printing. These are the activities which we are going to do on Monday. Like this, on Tuesday, again the conversation. In conversation, we are going to take domestic animals. Here on Monday, these animals were pet animals. Now, Tuesday, we are going to take domestic animals, and those domestic animals are cow and goat. Story, rhymes, riddles. Then cognitive development, matching, again matching activity. Puzzles, you can give them puzzles through 2 pieces puzzles or 3 pieces puzzles. Pre-number concept, big and small. Again, we have to repeat here. For fine motor development, coloring and sorting. Large motor, racing, walking on line. Again, for socio-emotional development, role play, we will repeat the same. And for creativity and aesthetic appreciation, music and movement, we will do, we will play the music and children will move their body, and thumb printing. In this way, we can proceed further. On Wednesday, we will select the activities from there. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Saturday will mostly for repetition. The whole weeks, whatever we have done, on Saturday, we repeat the same activities here. So, this is the activities for weekly plan and daily planning. So, dear learners, now you have come to know then how to plan and how many types of program planning can be divided into long term, medium term and short term, and how to plan weekly and daily. Thank you.